He is immortal. Born in the Highlands of Scotland 400 years ago, he is not alone. There are others like him. Some good, some evil. For centuries, he has battled the forces of darkness, with holy ground his only refuge. He cannot die unless you take his head and with it his power. In the end, there can be only one. He is Duncan MacLeod, the Highlander.
Duncan MacLeod of the Clan MacLeod.
You're gonna be all right.
Tommy Bannon?
That was his name.
And you never came across this Galen before?
No.
He must have been more than he bargained for.
It was an even match, Richie.
Then how come he took off?
I don't know.
Oh, too bad about the Bannon kid. Guy was in the wrong place at the wrong time.
There's no reason for him to be dead, Richie.
You didn't hit the guy, Mac. You think that Galen is losing sleep over this?
Hey, I'm not Galen.
Take it easy. I didn't say you were. You want to talk about it?
No. You want some breakfast?
Sure. Look, Mac. If you don't want to discuss it, I understand. But there's nothing you can do for Tommy Bannon.
I can go to his funeral.
I'm Betty Bannon. I don't think we've met.
I'm Duncan MacLeod.
You're the one that tried to save him.
I'm sorry it wasn't enough.
You did what you could. I thank you for that with all my heart.
I should be going.
Would you stay a while, Mr. MacLeod? Please. You were the last one to see my Tommy alive.
Of course. You do that very well.
Do you think you're the first man who ever courted me?
Only if the men around here are fools.
The girls say that men are like horses. Big and stupid. But they do have their uses.
You comparing me to a horse?
Well, you're certainly not stupid. But as for uses...
Bastard! Get out of the wagon!
Who are you?
That's Ned.
Her fiancé.
Your fiancé? We have to talk about this.
Bess and I will talk about it when you're dead. She was sworn to marry me.
It was my parents' idea, not mine.
Give me satisfaction.
Well, you have me at a slight disadvantage.
Then get out and arm yourself.
Duncan, please. Duncan, please.
Tell him, not me.
Come down and meet your fate.
Ned. Let this go before it is more harmful.
Ned, do not hurt him.
Whoops.
No. Duncan, watch out. Ned, stop it. Duncan.
No, Bess, stay back.
Bess. Dear God. Bess?
Be dead.
I would.
She was supposed to marry Ned, then you came. And now Ned will be court-martialed and we have nothing.
We'll have whatever you need, I swear, anything.
Can you bring Bess back? She was my only child. May you rot in hell.
raised Tommy by myself. My husband died in Vietnam. He'd only been an American citizen 3 years.
I'm sorry.
He was a soldier. After he was gone, I thought about going home to the Highlands. Someday I'd like to go back there to live.
Why don't you?
Oh, money. Tommy helped with expenses, but he was just a reporter.
What kind of reporting did he do?
Investigative. He wanted his own byline, but he was always working undercover. He promised me that one day I'd see his name. I don't know why I'm telling you all of this.
You can tell me what you like.
Mr. MacLeod, are you... Was it really an accident?
What do you mean?
Well, I don't know, but the last time I saw Tommy, he was really scared about something. It was like he thought he was in danger.
From what?
Well, he wouldn't tell me. He said it was for my own protection.
Betty, I am so sorry that we're late.
That's all right, Suzanne. You're here now.
I don't believe him at my father, Mr. Honegger.
My sympathies, Mrs. Bannon.
Thank you. This is Duncan MacLeod. He tried to save Tommy.
I better thank Mr. MacLeod.
Tommy was a fine young man. We'll miss him at the paper.
Will you forgive us if we run? We have a board meeting at 4.
She's not the type. But my Tommy was in love with her.
Mrs. Bannon, if you need anything at all, don't hesitate to call. Us Highlanders have to stick together.
Think Galen's not in town to hunt you, Mac.
Because he didn't know my name before we fought. It was a chance meeting. What I can't figure is what he was doing in that cemetery.
Unless he was reacquainting himself with some old pals, Mac. He had to be after you.
No, he couldn't have known I'd be there. And if he followed me, I would have sensed him.
That's true. Okay, so if he wasn't there for you, and we know he wasn't sentimental about Tommy Bannon, who's left?
Well, there's Betty Bannon, but I don't think so. And there's Suzanne, his girlfriend. And her father, Mike Honegger, who he worked for.
Honegger? The guy's no immortal, but he does own Honegger Communications. That's 3 newspapers and half a dozen TV and radio stations.
Maybe. Well, maybe it wasn't a coincidence that Tommy was there when I fought Galen. Maybe he was investigating Galen for Honegger's paper.
Exactly. This could have something to do with Galen's immortality.
Maybe.
I tell you what. I'm gonna go down to Honegger's paper today and ask a few questions.
He has a few questions I want to ask, too.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I've come to see Mr. Honegger.
Do you have an appointment?
No, I'm afraid I don't.
Well, then you couldn't see him even if he was in.
Thank you. Mr. Honegger.
Mr. MacLeod, it's nice to see you again.
Call me Duncan.
Should I call security?
No, that's all right, Claire. My father's not in at the moment. Didn't Claire tell you?
Yes, she did, but I saw a guy leaving here as if he'd just been fired.
He has just been fired. I've been a vice president at Honegger Communications for 2 years. I assure you I've earned the title.
Nice pieces.
Yeah, my father's quite the collector of things. Now, what can I do for you?
Do you know what Tommy was working on before he died?
No. We didn't talk much about his assignments. Why?
Betty seems to think his death was tied to whatever he was working on.
She thinks that it was deliberate? You were there. You told the police it was an accident.
It seemed that way at the time.
And now?
I'm not sure.
If there is any chance this wasn't an accident, we have to find out. My father might know what he was working on.
Do you think I can talk to him?
Yeah. Why don't you come by the house this afternoon?
Okay.
Get you a card. Tommy and I were good friends.
Betty told me. I'm sorry.
Yeah, we're from different worlds, but it worked for us. I just want to tell you how much I appreciate all you've tried to do.
See you this afternoon?
Yes.
Excuse me. I'm looking for a friend of mine. His name's Tommy Bannon.
Never heard of him. What's he do?
He works up here. He's a reporter.
Not that I know of.
Well, you know Tommy Bannon. He works specials.
Specials? Is that kind of like undercover?
Yeah, that's right. Undercover. Sure, I remember him now.
Short guy.
Yeah, about 5'5".
Balding, about 40.
I was always thinking he looked older.
You know, I told him he would look a lot younger if he wore a piece.
Well, I don't see him around.
That's some story the guy's working on, huh?
Oh, some story.
He talked to you guys about it?
Nope.
No, the man kept pretty much to himself, you know? Hey, yeah. Plaxen, take this over to Petrovitz.
So, where's his desk?
I think he worked mostly out of his home.
Yeah, a lot of investigative guys do that. It's kind of a personality thing.
Yeah, right.
Listen, we got a paper to get out here.
Yeah, sure. If you guys do see Tommy, you tell him I'm looking for him, okay?
Yeah, sure. Listen, what'd you say your name was?
Richards. Jordan Richards. Take care, boys.
See you later, Jordan.
Yeah, Frank.
They had no idea who Tommy Bannon was, Mac. They didn't even know he was dead.
And why would Mrs. Bannon and Honegger say that he worked there when he didn't?
That's just the thing he did. You see, I went down to payroll. I told him I'm a friend of Tommy Bannon's. He's sick, wants me to pick up his paycheck. It was for $2,000.
Nice salary for a guy without a desk or a phone extension.
Exactly. So now what?
Well, now the Honeggers are expecting me.
The Honeggers? Well, that would include Suzanne. I'm correct, right? I checked out her picture, Mac. Maybe you need some company. You know, you talk to her father, I talk to her.
Richie, this is work. It's not like I'm going to enjoy it.
So let me do it. I mean, Suzanne Honegger's only, what, 28 years old?
25. And incredibly beautiful.
25? And how old are you?
400. But you know what, Richie? Today I feel like a kid.
Duncan MacLeod.
In here, please. Mr. Honegger will be with you in a moment.
Like it? It's a Luigi Balda, turn of the century Italian. Would you believe I got it for almost nothing?
That depends on what you call almost nothing.
Under 20,000.
Then you got a bargain.
Always nice to get an expert opinion. Drink?
No, thanks.
Really? My father always told me to be suspicious of men who don't drink.
Are you suspicious of me?
Actually, I'm curious.
About what?
Well, what you were doing at that amusement park so early in the morning.
I was out jogging, minding my own business. Whose business was Tommy minding?
Mine. Please. Look, Suzanne told me about Mrs. Bannon's worries. So I checked with my editors. Tommy wasn't working on anything that could have gotten him killed.
Do you mind if I ask what he was working on?
Do you mind telling me why you're so interested in him?
When a man dies in your arms, you get interested.
Exactly what kind of antique dealer are you, MacLeod?
You should know that. You checked me out, didn't you?
Man in my position can't be too careful.
And what position is that?
On top.
Don't worry about Daddy, Mr. MacLeod. He's suspicious of everybody, including me. Please.
My daughter graduated from Vassar in 3 years and got her master's from Wharton in 1, but she has a lot to learn about real life. Survival is not learned from reading a book.
Please, Daddy, no more stories about fighting with baseball bats to get the best newspaper route.
For someone who wants to run my companies, you're incredibly naive. Mr. MacLeod here has lived here and in Paris and in half a dozen other cities. His name turns up in a stack of unsolved police files. Some antique dealer.
That piece over there is worth $40,000. It came from Vienna, not Italy, and the carver is Wolfgang Bosch. Who's Luigi Baldi, your hairdresser?
My attorney.
Touché. Nicely done, Mr. MacLeod.
Thank you.
You're welcome. So, about Tommy?
Your father doesn't think there's a connection.
Frankly, neither do I. Those calls that I made, nothing. If he was working on something, he kept it to himself.
Did he keep any notes anywhere?
He had an apartment in the Rivercrest Arms, the corner of Rivercrest and Watson. You might try there.
You'd be wasting your time.
It's mine to waste.
As you like. Good day, Mr. MacLeod.
Good day.
Send you.
Go to hell!
You first.
Very brave, but not very smart. Come on! I mean, think about it. You might chip a tooth down there.
All right. It was Honegger.
That was who? Now why?
Come on!
My hands are getting tired!
All right. Okay. He thought somebody was trying to kill him.
And?
He pays big money to know what's going on in the street. And the word came back that there was a contract out on his life. And they figured it was you.
Why me?
Because of your file. Because of your history with the cops. Because you killed Tommy Bannon.
Why would I hit Tommy Bannon?
How the hell should I know? All right. His Honegger said whoever hit Tommy was out to kill him. Okay? Now let me up.
Say please.
Hey, you.
Please. Pretty please.
Please.
I don't like letting you out of my sight. Now, it's not that I don't trust you, but...
Oh. Oh, what has trust got to do with it? You are being well paid in more ways than one. Didn't I warn you about Tommy?
Little bastard was good. I never thought he'd find me. MacLeod's next.
Don't worry about him. Daddy thinks he's the hitman who's after him. He's sending Johnson to take care of him.
Johnson will fail.
How do you know?
Because I know. You leave MacLeod to me. You understand me?
You're hurting me. I love it when you play
Mrs. Bannon?
I'm sorry to bother you.
It's okay. When I offered to help, I meant it. What can I do for you?
I need your advice.
Then you're gonna have to tell me what it's about.
What Tommy's lawyer called. He told me Tommy's will left me everything. There wasn't much. Except a key to a safety deposit box.
So you opened it? What did you find?
There's over $200,000 in cash in there. Duncan, Tommy was just a reporter. Where would he get that kind of money?
I don't know. What are you going to do with it?
Well, my mother said, don't look a gift horse in the mouth.
Then use it. Go back to the Highlands. It's what Tommy would have wanted.
Well, thought of that. But without knowing where he got it.
All right, I understand. Just put it in the bank for now. There's nothing wrong with just having it.
I still don't see why Johnson couldn't drive
us. Oh, Daddy, we never get to spend time alone together. It'll be fun. Damn, I forgot. I gotta get those bank proposals.
I'll wait. Johnson, let's go. I told you to stick close to us. Hello?
Hello, Mr. Honecker.
Who is this? How'd you get this number?
Your daughter gave it to me. She also gave me a message for you.
What message?
She told me to tell you. Goodbye.
Grief-stricken to work.
Life goes on.
Not for everyone. What was worth $8,000 a week?
What do you mean?
I got hold of Tommy's pay stubs and ran his social security number. Your father was paying him $2,000 a week through four different companies. No tax evasion charges for little old Tommy.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Of course you do. You know everything that goes on in this company.
You're right, I do. I am this company. My father hasn't made a decision of his own in years.
Oh, Daddy's little girl. Couldn't you wait until he handed over the reins?
Daddy was a very healthy man. I would have had to wait 20 or 30 years. Patience never was one of my virtues. This man killed my father. Take care of him.
Remember me?
Yeah, you're the guy that's afraid of heights.
Not here.
Your pants still wet?
Get him out of here.
Was a funeral.
It was wonderful. Even the governor was there.
So how much are you worth now?
$287 million, but who's counting?
Since I did the job, I'll take my money.
That was 1 million.
Two.
My mistake.
It's a bargain. Cheers.
Cheers. I'll get it.
You know, maybe in a couple of months, I could come back, huh? You'd have a lot of fun.
I don't think you'll be coming back.
You may be surprised.
I don't think so.
Good!
surprise.
Like the stroke of a sword, 1 second is life, next second is gone. I don't want him to die. That fight isn't their fight. I should have stopped
him. No, best stay back!
We have to be careful. Human life is too fragile. Tommy, Bess, all of them, life is so fragile. No matter what you do, death comes when it's ready. On its own time, not yours. You can't keep them forever.
I don't remember my father, Mr.
Hunter. Why didn't you say goodbye?
Tommy's a fine young man, obviously.
Galen killed Tommy, but why killed him? Our fight isn't his fight.
If there is any chance this wasn't an accident,
why kill Tommy? Galen knows. Something is missing.
They had no idea who Tommy Bannon was.
Suzanne.
They didn't even know he was dead.
Suzanne and Tommy.
They didn't even know he was dead.
Tommy dies.
His name turns up in his
head. And Honigger dies. What's the connection? Tommy's working for Honigger. What's he really doing there? Gaylor was death.
Your father was paying him $2,000 a week.
But who was Tommy?
No tax evasion charges for little old Tommy.
Death comes at this other time.
Forget about the band and the kid.
What was Tommy doing there? Tommy and Galen, something's missing.
Yeah.
Tommy wasn't in the wrong place. Tommy was in the right place. Tommy was there for a reason, but the reason wasn't me.
You'd be wasting your time.
Tommy's dead. Honigger's dead. Suzanne in the center.
Mr. MacLeod.
It's all connected. Tommy was there for a reason.
Was it really an accident?
Maybe Tommy was death too.
You'd be wasting your time.
It's all connected.
May you rot in hell!
It has to be connected.
That look familiar?
Hold on. No, not from this angle.
You got a smart mouth, but not for much longer. Miss Honigger said to get rid of you, but she doesn't much care how.
You had a good time when you were up here where I am now.
Why don't you just shut up and let me go?
Say please. Have a nice flight.
I say we go back and have a little chat with your friend Suzanne.
She's not going to tell us anything.
All right, well, in that case, do we have any idea what we're looking for?
No, we'll know when we find it. What we know is that Tommy was being paid a ton of money by Honigger for something. That Galen went out of his way to kill him. And when Galen first jumped me, it was over. The fight took us halfway up the roller coaster. And Galen got hold of me, pushed me down. When I looked back, he disappeared. I looked down here, and Tommy was standing here by his Corvette.
Stand here a minute.
As Tommy was standing this way, Galen's car came from the right, it accelerated, went straight for Tommy, and it hit him.
So obviously, he nailed Tommy on purpose.
Questions why.
Mac, what are you doing?
Looking for something. I think I just found it. Catch. A 9mm hitman's weapon.
How'd you know this bag was down there?
Tommy was holding it, it went flying when he was hit.
Well, if Tommy was carrying a gun.
And he was coming to kill Galen.
Thank you.
Nice of you to drop in.
Well, we have some unfinished business. But this time we won't be interrupted, will we?
You're the one who killed Honegger.
And Honegger knew you were coming after him, so he sent Tommy to stop you.
He should have used that. I didn't want to have to handle both of you. But now, I'm all yours, MacLeod, huh?
Really? How much is she paying you?
The bitch tried to double-cross me. She actually tried to kill me.
Come on, Mac, let's take this son of a bitch.
No, Richie, one-on-one. You know the rules.
That's right, Richie. You run along now and live a little longer, huh? I'll see you soon enough.
I doubt it.
Well, shall we rock and roll?
Come! Come!
Tommy? But this is today's paper. How could he? You wrote this.
I just put the words on the paper because of Tommy that loves people were caught.
Well, the money, the 200,000.
Well, sometimes when a reporter's on a risky assignment, he can ask for the money up front.
So, the money really was his?
It's yours.
Thank you. You've brought my Tommy back to me. If you could use some of that money...
Take it. Go back to Scotland, back to the Highlands like you wanted. See them for me.
I will. Duncan, when I'm over there, you'll come visit me?
That's a promise.